All right, guys, welcome to your 19th tutorial in JavaScript. And in this lesson, I'm going to be talking to you guys about something called loops. Now, a loop is extremely useful in JavaScript and pretty much every computer programming language because it basically saves time. Anytime you need to do something repetitive, a loop comes in handy. For example, if you wanted to write like document.write, let's write something stupid. I love Rebecca Black. And if you wanted to write this like 10 times on the screen, then yes, you could go ahead and copy this and paste, 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 paste. But you know what? That's going to get jumbled. Look how messy it is already. And you know, it's just not a very efficient way of doing things. So wouldn't it be cool if there is a way where we could take a line of code and write it once and just tell JavaScript, do that 10 times, or do that 20 times, or do it 100 times? Well, it's going to save you a whole lot of typing. So let me show you guys one way to do that. One way to do that is called the for loop, and it's F-O-R. In the syntax, the basic body to set up this loop is for, and then you write two parentheses, and in your curly braces, or curly brackets, what the heck is like the regular, the professional educational name for these, because I always say curly braces, and I know they're not parentheses because these are parentheses. So if someone knows, let me know, send me a message. So anyways, the syntax for this is you have for, and inside here you're gonna tell it how many number of times to run, and here you write what bit of code you want to run. So document dot write, and then just go ahead and write you know, I love Rebecca Black. And let's go ahead and add a break to that. Actually, that needs to be in here. Break. And this would just, whenever we print it out, it will move on to the next line. So you're saying, all right, simple enough. But you don't go ahead and just write a number like 10 in there, or else whenever you try to run it, it's not going to work. That would just be way too easy. For syntax, or excuse me, the for loop is set up in a very specific way. It takes three different statements inside this little condition. The first statement is you need to make a variable and you need to give it a starting point. So you actually don't even need the name var like that. You just need to go ahead and name it because it's going to be expecting a variable. So go ahead and make a variable named x and set it equal to 0. 0 and 1 is basically always your starting point. And now you need to give it an ending point. So you don't just say something like x equals 60. You actually need to say x is less than 10. And the reasoning behind this is x is going to start at 0 and it's going to keep printing this out until x reaches above 10. So if you're saying, all right, so is it automatically going to add 1 to it each time, or add 3 to it each time, or how do I know how much to increment x by each time? Well, that is actually the last statement we're going to put. The last statement is how much do you want that value to go up by. So remember that x plus plus, plus plus was a special sign for add 1 to it each time. So you can put something like x plus equals 3, and now if we go ahead and save this, it's going to print it out 4 times. And it printed this out 4 times because the first time it said x equals 0. So is 0 less than 10? Yes, so print it out. The next time is 3, 6, and 9. So 0, 3, 6, and 9 is 4 times where it's less than 10. The next time, 12, it's greater than 10, so that's why it doesn't run. So that's what you can do, but most people just always put x plus plus. And this means start at 0, go all the way until you get more than 10. So let's go ahead and save this and check it out. It starts at 0. It goes 0, and I'm talking what the value of x is right now. X equals 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then the next one, when x is equal to 10, it doesn't print out. And the reasoning behind this is 10 less than 10? No, 10 is equal to 10. So that's why it doesn't print out. So that is how you can get JavaScript to print out a certain line or a certain bit of code a certain number of times. You can either do this and, you know, you can start at 5, and you can go to, 450 if you want by ones. Check it out. Refresh. Oh yeah, look at that huge list there. I love Rebecca Blacks. So anyways, just keep this in mind. If you ever like get in trouble in school, and as your punishment you have to type out I love Rebecca Black, which would be a very good punishment, 150 times, this is a nice little trick to save you from actually having to type it out. So that's all I have for you guys for this tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed, and yeah, I guess I'll see you in the next tutorial.